Why do people fail in functional testing? Functional testing is one of the oldest methods of software testing, however still people fail to achieve it correctly. Are we following the right practices to perform functional testing? In order to deliver a high-quality product, it is important to perform both functional and non-functional testing. Functional testing involves black box testing where the main focus is on the validation of functionalities from an end user's perspective. It verifies all the features and functionalities of an application and evaluates whether it meets the specified business requirements or not. Functional testing can be done manually as well as via automation. Functional testing process includes identifying the functionalities of software which need to be tested, creating sample input for the specified test cases, determining the output based on software expectations, execution of sample input, and comparing the expected output and actual output. Best practices to correctly achieve functional testing are maintaining a requirement traceability matrix which helps to eliminate the possibility of missing any functionality. Planning and execution of test cases which are the crucial processes for validating workflows in the software application. Initial planning of test cases using automation tools which results in significant time saving later. Reporting and analyzing test results with a summary of execution and defects helps in further planning and prioritizing the features and bugs involved. Webmates CQ helps in delivering quick test results by using multiple channels like automation, crowdsource, manual, AI automation. Our functional testing includes not only test case-based testing but also exploratory testing. We guarantee full regression of every test case in under 24 hours and provide triaged video defects. Read more regarding why do people fail in functional testing? At Webmates blog mentioned in the description of this video.